The ongoing chip shortage means that it could be tougher to buy everything from a game station to a Ford Mustang. For the next few months, maybe even until the fall. How did this happen? And what does this mean for you? But wait, besides automakers struggling with a pandemic-induced plant shutdowns and a global chip shortage, we are now confronting another supply chain headache, dwindling rubber supplies. How is this possible? How did this happen? Welcome back to the channel, I'm Lauren Fix. If this is your first time to the channel, we give you more than car reviews and first looks of new vehicles, we give you car smarts, because knowledge is power. Make sure to subscribe and click that little bell so you don't miss anything. The impact of these shortages has caused car companies to stop production of vehicles, which means less cars for dealers to sell, which means not that many incentives or deals, and it also means used car prices are on the rise again. But why did this happen? The pandemic caused slowdowns in production of semiconductor chips and an explosion of gaming devices, phones, and other electronics while people were in their home globally. China was a little bit more proactive. They gobbled up as many of these chips while many manufacturers were not even buying because there was no demand. And that high demand is now there, and that left them with a supply shortage. There were 30 companies producing chips a few years ago, but many have outsourced that work and it's reduced the production down to just a handful of suppliers. Even if a company designs their own chips, they typically don't produce them. Companies like Taiwan Semi-Conductor Manufacturing Company or Intel and others have been outsourcing them to other countries, including China. Now there are a few US chip manufacturers, we've heard about them, but they're also being impacted as well. They need materials. It's important to know that a semiconductor chip is not the same and it's not interchangeable with a phone or a car. Each is specific to its application. Now, all this great tech that we show you in cars in our reviews require a special chip, and the demand is high as production ramps back up and the demand for new vehicles is at an all-time high. As we add more safety technology and electric cars, the demand is way more than the supply can handle. Many car manufacturers are now taking back control of this required product, but they won't be able to ramp that up just fast enough. So what does that really mean for you? If you're looking for more car information, check out my book, Lauren Fix's Guide to Loving Your Car. The link is down below. That's not all. With a rubber shortage looming over suppliers, we have another issue. Rubber from trees is used in wiper blades, belts, bushings, weather strip, and so much more. Where did all the rubber go? Well, there was low demand for car parts and high demand for rubber gloves. So rubber suppliers saw an increased demand and they sent it all to rubber glove manufacturers. Rubber grows on trees in warm climates like Thailand, and the shortage could be here for quite a while. The reason for that is it takes several years, about 7 years, for a rubber tree to grow mature enough to use the material. So don't be surprised next time you buy a new set of tires and it costs you a few more bucks than normal, maybe a lot more. Here's the bottom line. The demand for new cars is high. Fewer choices are available on the lots, and people are now looking at used cars, which also have increased in price by about 10 to 15%. The average price of a new vehicle has increased from $34,000 to $40,000, and there are fewer incentives and deals available to you. Now, every brand is affected, and if you're looking for a deal, you might want to look at sedans. They tend to sit on the lot a little bit longer than SUVs and trucks. But Economics 101 says high demand, low supply, and the prices are less negotiable. Wait until the fall if you're really looking for a car or a truck or an SUV, where the rubber shortage and the chip shortage might be gone. When cars are back on the lot, there'll be more negotiation, there'll be lower price on used cars, and better prices on new vehicles. If you got value from this video, give it a like and subscribe for more videos like this one. If you have any questions about the chip shortage or rubber shortage or even the gasoline shortage, put that in the comments down below and I'll be happy to answer your question. Also, check out my social media. We do have some more conversation about the chip shortage and you can find more on my website, carcoachreports.com. It's in English and in Spanish, and you can follow me on all forms of social media at Lauren Fix. I'm always posting some interesting things that do impact you on an everyday basis. We've been discussing this on our podcast, Total Car Score. It's on all platforms and hopefully you'll give it a listen. Thank you so much for watching. And we'll look forward to seeing you next time.